So, Jalen, thank you for joining us. I'm going to go right in. Through three games, you guys are still looking for a W in the win column. How do you get it done? Give me your opinion.
I think the biggest thing right now, and even the message, you know, that Coach has been giving us as a team and individuals is those little bitty small details, you know, that we're missing on. You know what I'm saying? Whether it's communication, whether it's alignment, or even, you know, those self-inflicted penalties, man, we just can't have them. We can't give our opponent anything for free. You know, we got to try to make it as hard on them as they're doing it for us.
So, and also through the first three games, you are the leading Eagle in tackles. In total tackles, you lead the team. You're second on tackles for losses. So it seems to be that you're settling into this new position at safety. What's the most difficult part for you in this new position?
I would think it would be the communication part. You know, we have some calls and some coverages where, you know, I'm not only talking to, you know, my corner, telling him that we're in man. You know, we may have some zones and different other calls where I may have to talk to the defensive end, where I may have to talk to the linebacker, where I may have to talk to the safety in the middle of the field, you know. So I think the biggest thing is always being keyed in and locked in to where knowing the personnel and when I get a certain call that, okay, these are the guys that I have to communicate so I can just speed my process up.
Gotcha. So I also noticed that you're taking on a bigger workload. The week before, you had 99% of the snaps or 100% of the snaps and then 99% of the snaps. How are you holding up with that type of work?
The best thing that happened to me was Malcolm being here and my 4 years being with him and seeing, you know, how he took care of his body on and off the field, whether it's diet, you know, getting in the cold tub, you know, getting in the treatment room and, you know, any little nick, you know, us football players, we want to be tough guys. You get a little nick here and there, you're like, it'll go away. But, you know, Malcolm, you know, anything, you know, whether it was a thumb, an ankle, a hip, whatever, he was getting it in the training room and getting that pain or whatever it may be right out of his system. So he can feel his best on Sunday.
So you guys are going up against a Rams or a 49ers team that's very similar to the Rams from a couple of weeks ago. What is it about that offense, that style of offense, that gives you so much trouble?
They give you so many different looks out of so many different personnels. And I think the biggest thing with them is, you know, eyes. Whoever you have when you line up, you know, you just have to glue your eyes on him regardless of, you know, all of the window dressing that they're doing with the motions and the shifts and different things like that. You just got to glue your eyes, you know, to your key. And I think that's going to be the key to us, you know, as a defense playing dominant and getting a victory.
So, Jalen, I've been on teams that were in this situation where we didn't have wins and the offense may start pointing at the defense or the D-line may start pointing at the back end of the defense. How do you guys keep that from happening, keep your club from splintering and just going off in different directions?
Everybody's here to win 1 week at a time. You know, we have fallen short, you know, these past 3 weeks, but at the end of the day, the mission isn't over. You know what I'm saying? It is week three, and I know that kind of sounds, you know, crazy, like, oh, like those first 3 weeks didn't matter, but they did. And I think the biggest thing is we got true competitors on this team, and when you don't start the way that you know that we can, I think it just fuels everybody to just want to go harder for each other.
So when I look at their offense, they play a lot of two tight end sets. They play a lot of two back sets. They want you to keep your base personnel on the field. What's the big issue with that when you got bigger people on the field?
And you even go to, you know, the two tight end personnel. They got a guy over there who's top two tight end in the league. When you go bigger personnel with them, you know, they're gaining an extra receiver with him and a blocker as well. So I think that's the biggest thing for them, knowing that they got that guy. And I'm talking about Kittle. He can be a matchup problem sometimes if, you know, you do have a linebacker on him or even sometimes safeties.
When I look at their personnel, it's probably Jimmy Garoppolo. He's probably not going to play. Nick Mullins. What can you tell us about Nick Mullins?
Same exact system. You see sometimes, you know, if a quarterback goes down 1 week, you know, they might still be in the same system with the starting quarterback. And then that following week, they kind of adjusted a little bit for the backup quarterback. So he's a little bit more comfortable, but it's the exact same offense. Actually on film, you know, they kind of look like the exact same player as far as the reads and progressions that they got the guys going through.
Well, they have one big difference in Kyle Juszczyk. Most teams in the league don't have a fullback. They have a fullback. They use him in a variety of ways. What kind of challenge does that present for you?
Yeah, He's a Swiss Army knife for them, man. They line him up at one, at receiver. They line him up in the slot. They line him up at fullback. They line him up at tight end. So I think what the biggest thing with that is knowing that he is a key part of the offense and keying in on him when he is in the game, because we know at any point he can be a difference maker for them.
Do we get the turnover this weekend?
That's the plan.
We're still waiting for a turnover.
That's the plan, man. We're trying to get the turnover. You know, we got a ski mask on the sideline, so I'm planning on, you know, trying to put that ski mask on this week for sure.
Jalen, thank you for joining us, and good luck out on the West Coast.
Thank you so much, man. Thanks for having me.